Welcome back, guys. We are going to take a quick look at the software for this BMS system. First of all, hook up the Bluetooth adapter to your BMS. In my first video, you saw that I did not get anything but Chinese characters or text in the application. It's time to remedy that. If we click on the application to start it up, as you can see, it's a big elephant for some reason. You will see that everything is in Chinese. And everything inside as well is in Chinese, as you can see here. There is a way to fix that. So let's close the application and we go to settings on your phone and we will go to language. And as you can see here, depending on your phone, of course, I have Swedish as first language and English as second. This should not really be a problem because the software should go to the second one if it doesn't recognize the first one. So let's change this to English. So now let's start up the application again. When changing the language, this can take some time. But as you see now, we have the application in English, at least the bottom part. The image is not in English at least. And the text inside here is also in English. As you can see when we are looking at the different types, not everything is translated, but most of it is. You see kilometers and stuff like that everywhere, and that's because this software is primarily made for e-bikes and other vehicles. If you go into settings, you can see stuff like parameter view. Still, not everything is translated. It takes some time to load data, but here you have it. So basically, all the information you need to look at while you are out working or traveling, you can see it here. One thing that I found very important to know about is the parameter settings. No matter what I did, I were not able to change the parameters. Let's say I changed it to 2.8 and I press submit and the application crashes. I have tried to change several parameters but not been able to do any one of them. So let's go in again. You can see that we have app settings and stuff like that as well. And you have for GPS and the kilometers. And you can see the normal battery state. I would say that this is exactly what you guys need. Here you can see what I was talking about earlier about the voltages being jumpy and jumps back and forth. For some reason, you can see three of the cells are way off. So just for fun, let's take my voltmeter and you will see that cell number 14 is 409 volt and on the display it is showing 0.7 and the first one is still 4.15. So basically what we can see in this application is that it's way off. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this very short video. The application in the mobile do work. Unfortunately, the voltage reading seemed to be way off. I'm not sure about that. I am still impending with the seller to see what's going on.